Hi, we got all our tasks figured out. We have deterministic data. Now, here's my workflow. If I just run the test locally in interactive GUI mode on Mac, the test will fail. It will fail because I actually took the screenshots in non-interactive mode inside a Docker container that matches what my CI expects. So all my tests are failing. So what do I do? How do I run the test locally? Well, we cannot just run the command. So what we will do is, in interactive mode, we're gonna fake this command. We'll say if Cypress config is interactive. Now, this is a hidden command, right? This is not part of documented Cypress config options, but because I work at Cypress, I'm allowed to do it. In this case, we're gonna introduce a fake command. Cypress commands add, and we'll just take what the command to match image snapshot. And when it runs, we are not going to take the snapshot. Instead, we'll just say skipping snapshot. And we can add, I don't know, eye emoji or something. Else, if we are in non-interactive mode, that means Cypress run, then we will actually register the true snapshot command. So now everything is passing, right? Only instead of actual snapshot command, we're just printing a log message. Instead, after you're happy with tests, after they passed, what you will do is you will do npm run docker run. Because we're not passing Cypress update snapshot, this will compare existing snapshots to the snapshots produced during the test. And the resolution should match, and everything should be either passing or not. The only thing here is that, as you can see, this requires you to run the command before you push code changes. So you have to remember that you must run npm run docker run before you push your commits. Now, another thing that you have to remember is that if there are mismatches in the snapshots, the test will fail. But for example, if you disabled one of the tests, right, skipping it, or maybe you removed it, there'll be orphan images inside the snapshot folder. So you have to periodically remember to review those images, make sure they're still valid and you're not just committing and keeping what is no longer being used. Okay, so the first spec all passed, generated all the snapshots, they match existing snapshots, and the second spec has passed. Okay, so this is how you work with snapshots locally. You ignore them in the interactive mode and you do use them in non-interactive mode by actually running a command that we just introduced.